Live.
Yeah.
Can you bring me my bread? Cheers. Welcome to the 2020 End of Year Award Ceremony. A few global events have happened in the past couple of months, so we've decided that if you can't come to us for your ceremony, we'll bring the ceremony to you. We've been working behind the scenes to give you a meaningful farewell to the college year and have done our best to bring everyone together remotely with this online event. So thank you for tuning in. We've enjoyed half the year on campus, and we know that all your hard work and determination to complete your studies from home has been truly commendable. Before we close the books on another college year, we want to take this opportunity to give you a heartfelt send-off and a grand well done for all your hard work. Let's get the ceremony started with a few words from our Chair of Governors, Maureen Vears, and our CEO and Principal, Dr. Tim Whittaker, and a special message from our staff. Then on to your live subject areas with your course mates and the best bits of the year. Over to you, Maureen.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 2020 Aspen Bryan College End of Year Celebration. This event is in many ways the most important day of a college year. It's when we all come together to celebrate the hard work and achievements of our students. This year we may have had to come together by computer screen, but I hope you've all put your best frocks on and that you will enjoy the event, and it will be a memorable experience for all of you. I'm proud to chair the college and just play a small part in the great work that it does for our students. This has been an unprecedented year for the whole world. The last time we had an epidemic of this scale, the grandparents of our students were mostly not even born. I could not be more proud of the way our staff and students have reacted to this crisis. The positive attitude, innovation, and energy that they have shown has been amazing, and I thank them for it. I think if there's one positive to come out of the COVID-19 epidemic, it's that the country has started to recognize the importance of practical skills. Key workers are not just hospital managers and consultants. They're nurses, they're firemen, they're police officers, they're delivery drivers. They're the people who grow our food, they're the people who look after our animals, they're the people who protect our environment. Many of our students are acquiring skills here which are going to be so important in this new world of ours, and I wish them the greatest of success. We're going to need them. The college is a complex and diverse organization, but all of this complexity is there for one reason, and that's to give our students the very best education that we can.
Be consumed because
I would like to thank the college staff for their professionalism and dedication throughout the year. I would also like to thank the family and friends of our students for the support they've given to them and for the fact that they're here to help us celebrate. And most of all, I would like to thank our graduating students for their hard work and determination. That's made our efforts worthwhile. That's what the college is for. I would now like to hand over to our Chief Executive and Principal, Tim Whittaker. Tim and his team do an amazing job in making sure that the college delivers a high-level experience for all of our students. Tim, thank you for your leadership and dedication in what has been a very challenging year. Thank you.
Thank you for that introduction, Maureen. Students, parents, colleagues, governors, and honoured guests, it gives me great pleasure to stand before you as principal of one of the UK's leading specialist land-based colleges. This is now my 6th year of graduations, and this is certainly one like no other. This, along with all staff at the college, is really one of our most favourite days of the year. Despite the current circumstances, this is absolutely a real opportunity for us all to celebrate. Askham-Brien College was established in 1937. We had a brief hiatus through the war years and opened for business in 1948 with 40 students enrolled, all male. Today we have over 5,000 students and play an incredibly important role in the regional and national economies. And yes, we have more female students than male students. We are a specialist land-based college. This is something we're extremely proud of and is absolutely core to what we do. Our staff are absolutely at the heartbeat of this organisation. Whether they're the highly skilled, technical, professional and academic staff delivering lectures and outstanding learning to our students, or those in the numerous and diverse but equally important specialist areas, whether that be our grounds team, those working in MIS, finance, in our canteens, in our marketing department, and the many, many more areas that I haven't mentioned. I genuinely hope as students during your time studying at the college, you have managed to fulfill your dreams and ambitions. The warm, yet friendly and challenging environment is one that I hope you have had the time to thrive in and have embraced as much of it as you possibly can. The events of recent months have been massively challenging to everyone. However, I really do think I should applaud you all for how you have adapted and coped with a fundamental shift in the way that you have learnt. It is a huge credit to you all. The way you have adjusted to this situation is something that you should all be incredibly proud of. I know this has been far from ideal. It's been upsetting. And I know that you will feel that you have missed out on your final months at college. But thank you all for your acceptance and your work. Your efforts have enabled us to stay safe and have saved lives. You should not underestimate your contribution. Your efforts show compassion, care, understanding, and truly prepare you as our future global citizens. I also, before I finish, must commend you on your academic performances. We have delivered some of our highest ever achievement rates. By being here today, at this virtual ceremony, you are marking the culmination of a significant amount of hard work and graft. Your tutors, your friends, your family have all supported you along the way, through the good times and perhaps through some of the tougher times. But the main person that has made this happen is you, and for that you should always be proud. Thank you.
I know you moved on to someone new. Life is beautiful. You were the light for me to find my truth. I just wanna say thank you. Leaving to find my soul. Told her I had to go. And I know it ain't pretty when our hearts get broke. Too young to feel this old. Watching us both turn cold. Oh, I know it ain't pretty when two hearts get broke. Yeah, I know it ain't pretty when two hearts get broke.
I hope someday we'll sit down together and laugh with each other about these days all our troubles we'll lay to rest and we'll wish we could come back to these days.
No.
To show for it now. And I know it ain't pretty when the fire burns out. Calling me when I'm drunk. Remind me of what I've done. And I know it ain't pretty when you're trying to move on.
Later.
Tim, do you want us all to have our video on or off or what?
The decision is yours. I think it's nice to have the video on.
Damn it, I can't go for a cup of tea.
But it's Italian, because I mean, otherwise you're just looking at a black screen, which I just think is horrible.
Yeah, okay.
Tim, I'm going to struggle because my computer's already struggling with Zoom as it is, so I don't think I'm going to be able to put my video on. I think that might just send it over the edge.
Right. Yeah, no problem.
No response from Sam on the phone. I know he's on site today.
Hiya. If it's Sam Riley Gunn, I just spoke to him. He had problems getting on, so he should be okay now.
Your cow isn't quite above your head, Richard.
Okay, folks, it's 10 o'clock. Are we good to go? Yeah. Okay. We going for admit all then, Rachel?
Thank you.
you bring me my broom? Cheers. Welcome to the 2020 End of Year Award Ceremony. A few global events have happened in the past couple of months, so we've decided that if you can't come to us for your ceremony, we'll bring the ceremony to you. We've been working behind the scenes to give you a meaningful farewell to the college year, and have done our best to bring everyone together remotely with this online event. So thank you for tuning in. We've enjoyed half the year on campus, and we know that all your hard work and determination to complete your studies from home has been truly commendable. Before we close the books on another college year, we want to take this opportunity to give you a heartfelt send-off and a grand well done for all your hard work. Let's get the ceremony started with a few words from our Chair of Governors, Maureen Vears, and our CEO and Principal, Dr. Tim Whittaker, and a special message from our staff. Then on to your live subject areas with your course mates and the best bits of the year. Over to you, Maureen.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 2020 Aspen Bryan College End of Year Celebration. This event is in many ways the most important day of a college year. It's when we all come together to celebrate the hard work and achievements of our students. This year we may have had to come together by computer screen, but I hope you've all put your best frocks on and that you will enjoy the event, and it will be a memorable experience for all of you. I'm proud to chair the college and just play a small part in the great work that it does for our students. This has been an unprecedented year for the whole world. The last time we had an epidemic of this scale, the grandparents of our students were mostly not even born. I could not be more proud of the way our staff and students have reacted to this crisis. The positive attitude, innovation, and energy that they have shown has been amazing, and I thank them for it. I think if there's one positive to come out of the COVID-19 epidemic, it's that the country has started to recognise the importance of practical skills. Key workers are not just hospital managers and consultants. They're nurses, they're firemen, they're police officers, they're delivery drivers. They're the people who grow our food, they're the people who look after our animals, they're the people who protect our environment. Many of our students are acquiring skills here which are going to be so important in this new world of ours, and I wish them the greatest of success. We're going to need them. The college is a complex and diverse organisation, but all of this complexity is there for one reason, and that's to give our students the very best education that we can. I would like to thank the college staff for their professionalism and dedication throughout the year. I'd also like to thank the family and friends of our students for the support they've given to them and for the fact that they're here to help us celebrate. And most of all, I would like to thank our graduating students for their hard work and determination. That's made our efforts worthwhile. That's what the college is for. I would now like to hand over to our Chief Executive and Principal, Tim Whittaker. Tim and his team do an amazing job in making sure that the college delivers a high-level experience for all of our students. Tim, thank you for your leadership and dedication in what has been a very challenging year. Thank you.
Thank you for that introduction, Maureen. Students, parents, colleagues, governors and honoured guests, it gives me great pleasure to stand before you as principal of one of the UK's leading specialist land-based colleges. This is now my sixth year of graduations, and this is certainly one like no other. This, along with all staff at the college, is really one of our most favourite days of the year. Despite the current circumstances, this is absolutely a real opportunity for us all to celebrate. Aspen Bryan College was established in 1937. We had a brief hiatus through the war years and opened for business in 1948 with 40 students enrolled. all male. Today, we have over 5,000 students and play an incredibly important role in the regional and national economies. And yes, we have more female students than male students. We are a specialist land-based college. This is something we're extremely proud of and is absolutely core to what we do. Our staff are absolutely at the heartbeat of this organisation. Whether they're the highly skilled, technical, professional and academic staff delivering lectures and outstanding learning to our students, or those in the numerous and diverse but equally important specialist areas, whether that be our grounds team, those working in MIS, finance, in our canteens, in our marketing department, and the many, many more areas that I haven't mentioned. I genuinely hope that students, during your time studying at the college, you have managed to fulfil your dreams and ambitions. The warm, yet friendly and challenging environment is one that I hope you have had the time to thrive in and have embraced as much of it as you possibly can. The events of recent months have been massively challenging to everyone. However, I really do think I should applaud you all for how you have adapted and coped with a fundamental shift in the way that you have learnt. It is a huge credit to you all. The way you have adjusted to this situation is something that you should all be incredibly proud of. I know this has been far from ideal. It's been upsetting. And I know that you will feel that you have missed out on your final months at college. But thank you all for your acceptance and your work. Your efforts have enabled us to stay safe and have saved lives. You should not underestimate your contribution. Your efforts show compassion, care, understanding, and truly prepare you as our future global citizens. I also, before I finish, must commend you on your academic performances. We have delivered some of our highest ever achievement rates. By being here today, at this virtual ceremony, you are marking the culmination of a significant amount of hard work and graft. Your tutors, your friends, your family have all supported you along the way, through the good times and perhaps through some of the tougher times. But the main person that has made this happen is you, and for that you should always be proud. Thank you.
I know you moved on to someone new. Life is beautiful. You were the light for me to find my truth. I just wanna say thank you. Leaving to find my soul. Told her I had to go. And I know it ain't pretty when our hearts get broke. Too young to feel this old. Watching us both turn cold. Oh, I know it ain't pretty when two hearts get broke. Yeah, I know it ain't pretty when two hearts get broke.
I hope someday we'll sit down together and laugh with each other about these days. All our troubles, we'll lay to rest and we'll wish we could come back to these days. To show for it now, and I know it ain't pretty when the fire burns out. Calling me when I'm drunk, remind me of what I've done. And I know it ain't pretty when you're trying to move on. Yeah, I hope someday.
cigarettes in the ashtray, reminiscing on those past days. I thought you didn't know where my last name, but that changed. And I traveled around the world, think where you living at now. I heard you moved to Austin, got an apartment and settled down. And every once in a while, I start texting, write a paragraph, but then I delete the message. Think about you like a pastime, I could cry you a river, get you baptized. Or I wasn't ready to act right, used to always think I'd get you back right. They say that things fall apart. We were gonna move to Brooklyn, you were gonna study art. Love is just a tool to remind us who we are, and that we are not alone when we're walking in the dark.
I hope someday we'll sit down together and laugh with each other about these days we left. All our troubles will let us rest. We wish we could come back to these days, these days. We wish we could come back to these days, these days.
Thank you, Maureen, Tim, and all the staff for your well wishes. As your SU president, I've seen you grow and develop both academically and socially, from the many hours you've spent in lessons to the long nights spent dancing and singing in the SU bar and at our events. This year has culminated quite differently compared to others, with us being unable to end the year with a bang at the annual summer ball. However, let's not dwell on things we've missed. Many of you, like me, will be stuck at home, using the Clap for Carers as a way to keep track of the days of the week, spent many hours sat in front of the TV watching several series, working, or volunteering within your local community. But one thing that I have learned in my 4 years of being at Askham is that no matter what is thrown at us, we always stick together, and we still show the true community spirit. It's that community spirit that has helped you through your time at Askham. One final thank you goes to all of you, the staff, students and parents, because without you I wouldn't have been able to have had the privilege to serve as your 2019-2020 SU President. So thank you. Now without further ado, let's continue the celebration, and at this time your ceremonies will go live to your subject areas. So in 3, 2, 1...
So I think I've got the privilege of going first, and I'm going to just say a quick thank you to all of the agriculture students. You have yet again another year where you've all been absolutely amazing. We're so proud of what you've achieved in terms of your success on your courses. The results are higher than they've ever been before and way above what we could have ever expected really to achieve. Not only that, you've all been an absolute delight to be around and a delight to teach. Your humour and dedication to your subject and the friendships within every group have just been a privilege for us to watch. You've been very lucky, I think, to be taught by some amazing staff. Sam and Richard and Harriet are three of the most dedicated and enthusiastic people you could have ever had had teaching you, but we've all also been very lucky to have taught you as well. The prize that I'm going to award today is for the best level two. Again, it's been an incredibly strong year. 25 has been a very big group of agricultural level twos, tested my nerve and stamina on many occasions. But one person who's excelled in every element of the course, practically, theoretically, mechanically and animally, is Lydia Emerson. Lydia's come from a non-fab farming background and has achieved her qualification as the highest in the whole of her group. So congratulations, Lydia, you are the winning Level 2 Agriculture student for this year. So take care, all of you, and I'm sure we'll see you all sometime soon in the future.
Hello, everybody. I think it might be gamekeeping's turn next. So, for The Newton Rigg Game and Wildlife Department, we're celebrating our 25th year of existence. I think that advert that's going about at the minute, which says life's like a wheel, one minute you're up, the other minute you're down, has well and truly summarised this year. But we've had some really good highs. We've had, again, exceptional performances. Our level twos and second year level threes, none of them achieved below a merit at the end exams, which is exceptional. And we've had national awards. We've had great involvement with our industry, which hopefully will continue. So a great big well done to everybody. But to name our prize winners, the first one I'd like to present is Lewis Stewart, who actually won the National Gamekeepers Frank Jenkins Memorial Trophy for the national best gamekeeping student. So this isn't just a college prize. Lewis has been declared the best gamekeeping student in the country, which is a massive achievement for the department. He was nominated for the National Award owing to his uniquely outgoing positive outlook on life. He was a natural leader within the group from the outset and has forged his own way into the shooting industry, achieving a most enviable first job as a royal gamekeeper on the Queen's Sandringham Estate. He well deserves his name on this national trophy, and I am sure we will see him reach the lofty heights of head keeper in short order. Our second award is our Matthew Tyson, Newton Rigg Best Gamekeeping Student. And for this, we've nominated and awarded Ella Stapley. Simply put, Ella has been one of the most competent and hardworking students of recent years in the Newton Rigg Gamekeeping Department. Everything in her time at college has been completed to the highest distinction standard, and she has shown a steely focus on gaining a role as a gamekeeper, which she's been successful in. She goes on to provide a shining example of how young women can pioneer their way into the game industry. And hopefully there'll be a good few more to follow her. We then have our level two award, best level two student, and we've nominated Ethan Duxbury for this. At the start of the year, students are told to let their game management skills speak louder than their words. Ethan has been the epitome of this throughout his course. He has worked in a quietly confident way, achieving all practical tasks to a high standard. He leaves Newton Rigg to continue the family gamekeeping tradition on the estate in North Wales. And it looks like I might have just dropped in over Richard there, so I'll pass back to agriculture.
Richard, you're on mute.
Hi, I think we've got a few problems with Richard's audio there. So if we can go straight to Jane Johnson, as she can move on to delivering the awards for level two and level three land-based technology. And we'll see if we can get Richard's microphone sorted. So go back to him afterwards. Over to you, Jane. Thank you.
Thank you. I'm reading out these awards on behalf of Scott White, the engineering course manager. Scott would like to start by saying to all the level two and level three engineering students that he's extremely proud of what you've achieved this year. The engineering department has made a lot of progress over the last year, and this has been achieved through your hard work and the way you as students have conducted yourselves around the campus. As all of you will be leaving Newton Rigg this year to pursue your careers, Scott would like to wish you all the very best for your future in whatever you decide to do. A big cheers from Scott. First of all, we've got the Level 2 Award, which goes to an individual that has shown excellence throughout. They have always been the first to produce their work to a very high standard. They have an excellent record of attendance and have shown they have what it takes to become an excellent engineer. That is why the Level 2 Award goes to Zach Baines. Well done, Zach. The Level 3 Award goes to an individual that has always given their all to whatever task they have been given. They have shown excellent practical skills and a willingness to go the extra mile to complete the work that's required. They have shown good leadership skills and are respected by staff and students alike. The Level 3 Land-Based Engineering Award goes to Matthew Beadle. So just to conclude, to say, to wish you all, on behalf of myself and Scott, all the best in your future careers. Over to you, Richard, if you've got any sound.
Can you hear me now?
Lovely.
You've got me sung this song.
Ready to you, Richard.
There we go.
Right, can you hear me? Sorry about that, don't know what's going on. So, ladies, gentlemen, honoured guests and graduates, it is my pleasure to award the prize for the best agricultural student on the Level 3 course. This has not been an easy task. We are seeing 34 young people graduate today, and each of them is unique in their own way with what they have brought to the group and wanted from the group. But there is one person who from day one dared put their head above the parapet and all the way through the course has absorbed the information they have been given. So it is my pleasure to award the Level 3 Agriculture Student of the Year to Luke Harrison.
And once again, we're having a few sound problems today, so we do apologise. So if I can call upon Rachel Waterhouse, and if Rachel would like to lead into the amazing awards and comments you have for your brilliant animal management students, that'd be fantastic. Thank you, Rachel.
Thank you, Tim. Can you hear me? Can I get some thumbs up? Yay, excellent. First of all, I'd like to make an award for Bethany Elliott on the Level 2 Animal Care course. I'm reading this on behalf of Felicity Parker, Bethany's course manager. All of the Level 2 have done so well this year, some fantastic grades coming through, but Bethany has stood out. She's a delightful and caring student who shows great support for her fellow students. She always puts all her attention into her work and shows great dedication to her field of interest. Bethany is compassionate about animals and takes care to ensure that everyone receives the best care possible. She's also known for her enthusiastic use of flashcards to support her learning. She has been an absolutely perfect student to teach. Well done, Bethany Elliott. And I do believe at this point we're going to go over to Darren to talk a little bit more about Bethany.
Hello. At this moment, we're going to give the Maths Award at Newton Rigg. And once again, we're going to give it to Bethany. And the reasons for that, I think, is she is such a positive, hardworking, friendly individual who is thoughtful and clearly respected by her peers. And very importantly, I find her to be inquisitive and open-minded, and so always willing to learn and learn from constructive criticism. So I think Bethany is an outstanding person. I think she'll be very successful in whatever she does in the future. And she'll be receiving our English award. I think if I said maths, it's the English award. So well done, Bethany.
Thank you very much, Darren. Well done, Bethany. Two awards, wow. I'd like to move on to the Extended Diploma in Animal Management, 1080s. And I'd like to make an award to Megan Dodd. There are so many deserving learners on the Extended Diploma, students who've worked really hard to overcome numerous obstacles to their success and who've triumphed over really difficult odds. I want to congratulate all of them on what they've achieved. The course reps this year, Erina and Charlie, rock on, you've been amazing and fantastic. I could talk endlessly about all of you, but I know that Tim will cut me off. Megan Dodd, however, does stand out. She doesn't stand out to the casual observer, maybe, but she's a top-class student. She has learned to work hard, to play hard. She's also learned to balance all of the different elements in her life while still getting good grades. When I rang Megan recently, she said, "Can't talk now, I'm up a fell moving some sheep." And the previous day I spoke to her, she says, "No, I've got to move out, I'm at the auction doing this and that." She gets up early to milk. This is an animal care student. She doesn't follow agriculture. She works on her own farm. She attends a placement at least 2 days a week. She goes on call at the vets the weekend. She mucks out horses for somebody else. And she completes all of her assignments on time to a good standard. This is excellent time management. She is unfailingly polite, although she has a really dry sense of humour. She's always willing to help out her classmates. She is absolutely reliable, capable, meets every challenge face on. And although she has been known to roll her eyes in business management classes, she's almost literally bomb-proof. We know she wants to progress on to veterinary nursing, and I believe her placement employer has offered to support her in this, and he will not regret his decision. Well done, Megan, and good luck from all of the team. Following on from Megan, we have another excellent learner. I'm reading this for Fran Foster, who is Sky Webster's course manager. Sky Webster is on the Extended Diploma 720. And Fran says that Sky has really developed into a great ambassador for Newton Rigg's Animal Management Department. She's excelled in the wildlife and zoo pathway she's followed this year. She always goes the extra mile, from erecting and maintaining bird feeders throughout college. Yes, it was Sky if you saw them around. To leading wildlife watch sessions for youngsters and attending early morning milking. There's a bit of a pattern here. Sky has been through a difficult time with many obstacles to overcome, but growing in her social interactions with people after the amazing bond she made with her barn owl and through the Learning with Horses program that we've put on at the college, Sky has become a really well-rounded young woman. She participates in martial arts at a high level. She's a talented musician and writer, and she's now working at Jackson's of Jedburgh full time. Well done, Skye, and we wish you all the very best for the future. And then I'd finally like to end up with our dog grooming course, level 2 dog grooming. And I'm reading this on behalf of Margaret Lee, and she's the course manager of the dog grooming students. They're only a small group, but they've done so well this year. Courtney Amos takes the award for the level 2 dog grooming. She's a dedicated student who is committed to her work. She puts the utmost effort into everything that she undertakes. She's enthusiastic, she's a popular member of the group, she's compassionate to others, but she's compassionate also to the dogs and understands their welfare. She's been an absolutely perfect student, and Margaret and the team wish her all the very best for the future. Well done, animal carers. Thank you.
And so we move from the smaller animals to the larger animals. So if we can pass over to Susanna. I know she has got a few broadband issues, so if she does drop out, we duly apologise. But we'll hopefully go across to Susanna now for our equine awards. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone.
congratulations and well done to all of our Level 2 and Level 3 equine students. You have been an absolute joy to teach this year, and overall we have had a very fabulous and very successful 1920 academic year. It gives me great pleasure to award the Newton Rigg Prize for Equine to Charlotte Gray. From the very beginning, Charlotte has impressed staff with her commitment and mature can-do, will-do attitude, regardless of whether completing practical or theoretical tasks. Throughout the course, Charlotte has produced work of a consistently high standard, achieving a distinction grade in the end-of-year exam, which is testament to her enthusiasm and dedication. We as a team feel that Charlotte is a real asset to the college and look forward to welcoming her back in September to resume the second year of her studies. Well done, Charlotte.
I'm drowning. your best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest.
You can beat the world, you can beat the war. You can talk the guy, go banging on his door.
You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock.
Yeah.
You can move a mountain, you can break rocks.
You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you go find yourself.
You can run the mile. You can walk straight through hell with a smile.
You could be the hero, you could get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought never could be broke.
Yeah, do it for your people, do it for your pride. And you're never gonna know if you never even try.
Do it for your country, do it for your name. Cause there's gonna be a day when you're
And that's a just big thank you for everyone who's joined us for the Leavers celebration for 2020. So good luck, all the very best. Please keep in touch, stay safe. Thank you, and we hope you've really enjoyed our virtual end of year celebration. Take great care.
Thank you. Well done, everybody.
Well done, everybody. Hold your pints up, boys and girls.
Well done. Congratulations. Good luck.
Well done, Jordan.
Cheers.
Cigarettes in the ashtray, reminiscing on those past days. I thought you didn't know where my last name, but that changed. And I traveled around the world, think where you living at now. I heard you moved to Austin, got an apartment and settled down. And every once in a while, I start texting, write a paragraph, but then I delete the message. Think about you like a pastime. I could cry you a river, get you baptized. Oh, I wasn't ready to act right. Used to always think I'd get you back right. They say that things fall apart. We were gonna move to Brooklyn, you were gonna study art. Love is just a tool to remind us who we are, and that we are not alone when we're walking in the dark.
I hope someday we'll see.
Thank you, Maureen, Tim, and all the staff for your well wishes. As your SU president, I've seen you grow and develop both academically and socially, from the many hours you've spent in lessons to the long nights spent dancing and singing in the SU bar and at our events. This year has culminated quite differently compared to others, with us being unable to end the year with a bang at the annual summer ball. However, let's not dwell on things we've missed. Many of you, like me, will be stuck at home, using the Clap for Carers as a way to keep track of the days of the week, spent many hours sat in front of the TV watching several series, working or volunteering within your local community. One thing that I have learned in my 4 years of being at Askham is that no matter what is thrown at us, we always stick together. And we still show the true community spirit. It's that community spirit that has helped you through your time at Askham. One final thank you goes to all of you, the staff, students and parents, because without you I wouldn't have been able to have had the privilege to serve as your 2019-2020 SU President. So thank you. Now without further ado, let's continue the celebration, and at this time your ceremonies will go live to your subject areas. So in 3, 2, 1...
So I think I've got the privilege of going first, and I'm going to just say a quick thank you to all of the agriculture students. You have yet again another year where you've all been absolutely amazing. We're so proud of what you've achieved in terms of your success on your courses. The results are higher than they've ever been before and way above what we could have ever expected really to achieve. Not only that, you've all been an absolute delight to be around and a delight to teach. Your humour and dedication to your subject and the friendships within every group have just been a privilege for us to watch. You've been very lucky, I think, to be taught by some amazing staff. Sam and Richard and Harriet are three of the most dedicated and enthusiastic people you could have ever had had teaching you, but we've all also been very lucky to have taught you as well. The prize that I'm going to award today is for the best level two. Again, it's been an incredibly strong year. 25 has been a very big group of agricultural level twos, tested my nerve and stamina on many occasions. But one person who's excelled in every element of the course, practically, theoretically, mechanically, and animally, is Lydia Emerson. Lydia's come from a non-fab farming background and has achieved her qualification as the highest in the whole of her group. So congratulations, Lydia, you are the winning level two agriculture student for this year. So take care, all of you, and I'm sure we'll see you all sometime soon in the future.
Hello everybody, I think it might be gamekeeping's turn next. So, for the Newton Rigg Game and Wildlife Department, we're celebrating our 25th year of existence. I think that advert that's going about at the minute, which says life's like a wheel, 1 minute you're up, the other minute you're down, has well and truly summarised this year. But we've had some really good highs. We've had, again, exceptional performances. Our level twos and second year level threes, none of them achieved below a merit at their end exams, which is exceptional. And we've had national awards, we've had great involvement with our industry, which hopefully will continue. So a great big well done to everybody, but to name our prize winners, the first one I'd like to present is Lewis Stewart, who actually won the National Gamekeepers Frank Jenkins Memorial Trophy for the National Best Gamekeeping Student. So this isn't just a college prize. Lewis has been declared the best gamekeeping student in the country, which is a massive achievement for the department. He was nominated for the National Award owing to his uniquely outgoing, positive outlook on life. He was a natural leader within the group from the outset and has forged his own way into the shooting industry, achieving a most enviable first job as a royal gamekeeper on the Queen's Sandringham estate. He well deserves his name on this national trophy, and I am sure we will see him reach the lofty heights of head keeper in short order. Our second award is our Matthew Tyson, Newton Rigg Best Gamekeeping Student. And for this, we've nominated and awarded Ella Stapley. Simply put, Ella has been one of the most competent and hardworking students of recent years. in the Newton Rigg Gamekeeping Department. Everything in her time at college has been completed to the highest distinction standard, and she has shown a steely focus on gaining a role as a gamekeeper, which she's been successful in. She goes on to provide a shining example of how young women can pioneer their way into the game industry. And hopefully there'll be a good few more to follow her. We then have our level two award, best level two student, and we've nominated Ethan Duxbury for this. At the start of the year, students are told to let their game management skills speak louder than their words. Ethan has been the epitome of this throughout his course. He has worked in a quietly confident way, achieving all practical tasks to a high standard. He leaves Newton Rigg to continue the family gamekeeping tradition on the estate in North Wales. And it looks like I might have just dropped in over Richard there, so I'll pass back to agriculture.
Richard, you're on mute.
Hi, I think we've got a few problems with Richard's audio there. So if we can go straight to Jane Johnson, she can move on to delivering the awards for level two and level three land-based technology. And we'll see if we can get Richard's microphone sorted. So go back to him afterwards. Over to you, Jane. Thank you.
Thank you. I'm reading out these awards on behalf of Scott White, the engineering course manager. Scott would like to start by saying to all the level two and level three engineering students that he's extremely proud of what you've achieved this year. The engineering department has made a lot of progress over the last year, and this has been achieved through your hard work and the way you as students have conducted yourselves around the campus. As all of you will be leaving Newton Rigg this year to pursue your careers, Scott would like to wish you all the very best for your future in whatever you decide to do. A big cheers from Scott. First of all, we've got the Level 2 Award, which goes to an individual that has shown excellence throughout. They have always been the first to produce their work to a very high standard. They have an excellent record of attendance and have shown they have what it takes to become an excellent engineer. That is why the Level 2 Award goes to Zach Baines. Well done, Zach. The Level 3 Award goes to an individual that has always given their all to whatever task they have been given. They have shown excellent practical skills and a willingness to go the extra mile to complete the work that's required. They have shown good leadership skills and are respected by staff and students alike. The Level 3 Land-Based Engineering Award goes to Matthew Beadle. So just to conclude to say, to wish you all on behalf of myself and Scott, all the best in your future careers. Over to you, Richard, if you've got any sound.
Can you hear me now?
Lovely.
Are you ready to turn this off?
Ready to you, Richard.
Oh, no.
Right. Can you hear me? Sorry about that, don't know what's going on. So, ladies, gentlemen, honoured guests and graduates, it is my pleasure to award the prize for the best agricultural student on the Level 3 course. This has not been an easy task. We are seeing 34 young people graduate today, and each of them is unique in their own way with what they have brought to the group and wanted from the group. But there is one person who from day one dared put their head above the parapet and all the way through the course has absorbed the information they have been given. So it is my pleasure to award the Level 3 Agriculture Student of the Year to Luke Harrison.
And once again, we're having a few sound problems today, so we do apologise. So if I can call upon Rachel Waterhouse, and if Rachel would like to lead into the amazing awards and comments you have for your brilliant animal management students, that'd be fantastic. Thank you, Rachel.
Thank you, Tim. Can you hear me? Can I get some thumbs up? Yay, excellent. First of all, I'd like to make an award for Bethany Elliott on the Level 2 Animal Care course. I'm reading this on behalf of Felicity Parker, Bethany's course manager. All of the Level 2 have done so well this year, some fantastic grades coming through, but Bethany has stood out. She's a delightful and caring student who shows great support for her fellow students. She always puts all her attention into her work and shows great dedication to her field of interest. Bethany is compassionate about animals and takes care to ensure that everyone receives the best care possible. She's also known for her enthusiastic use of flashcards to support her learning. She has been an absolutely perfect student to teach. Well done, Bethany Elliott. And I do believe at this point we're going to go over to Darren to talk a little bit more about Bethany.
Hello. Yeah, at this moment, we're going to give the Maths Award at Newton Rigg. And once again, we're going to give it to Bethany. And the reasons for that, I think, is she is such a positive, hardworking, friendly individual who is thoughtful and clearly respected by her peers. And very importantly, I find her to be inquisitive and open-minded, and so always willing to learn and learn from constructive criticism. So I think Bethany is an outstanding person. I think she'll be very successful in whatever she does in the future, and she'll be receiving our English award. I think if I said maths, it's the English award. So well done, Bethany.
Thank you very much, Darren. Well done, Bethany. Two awards, wow. I'd like to move on to the Extended Diploma in Animal Management 1080s. And I'd like to make an award to Megan Dodd. There are so many deserving learners on the Extended Diploma, students who've worked really hard to overcome numerous obstacles to their success and who've triumphed over really difficult odds. I want to congratulate all of them on what they've achieved. The course reps this year, Erina and Charlie, rock on, you've been amazing and fantastic. I could talk endlessly about all of you, but I know that Tim will cut me off. Megan Dodd, however, does stand out. She doesn't stand out to the casual observer maybe, but she's a top class student. She has learned to work hard, to play hard. She's also learned to balance all of the different elements in her life while still getting good grades. When I rang Megan recently, she said, "Can't talk now, I'm up a fell moving some sheep." And the previous day I spoke to her, she says, "No, I've got to move out, I'm at the auction doing this and that." She gets up early to milk. This is an animal care student. She doesn't follow agriculture. She works on her own farm. She attends a placement at least 2 days a week. She goes on call at the vets at the weekend. She mucks out horses for somebody else. And she completes all of her assignments on time to a good standard. This is excellent time management. She is unfailingly polite, although she has a really dry sense of humour. She's always willing to help out her classmates. She is absolutely reliable, capable, meets every challenge face on. And although she has been known to roll her eyes in business management classes, she's almost literally bomb-proof. We know she wants to progress onto veterinary nursing, and I believe her placement employer has offered to support her in this, and he will not regret his decision. Well done, Megan, and good luck from all of the team. Following on from Megan, we have another excellent learner. I'm reading this for Fran Foster, who is Skye Webster's course manager. Skye Webster is on the Extended Diploma 720. And Fran says that Skye has really developed into a great ambassador for Newton Rigg's Animal Management Department. She's excelled in the wildlife and zoo pathway she's followed this year. She always goes the extra mile, from erecting and maintaining bird feeders throughout college. Yes, it was Skye if you saw them around. To leading wildlife watch sessions for youngsters and attending early morning milking. There's a bit of a pattern here. Skye has been through a difficult time with many obstacles to overcome, but growing in her social interactions with people after the amazing bond she made with her barn owl and through the Learning with Horses programme that we've put on at the college, Skye has become a really well-rounded young woman. She participates in martial arts at a high level. She's a talented musician and writer, and she's now working at Jackson's of Jedburgh full time. Well done, Skye, and we wish you all the very best for the future. And then I'd finally like to end up with our dog grooming course, level 2 dog grooming. And I'm reading this on behalf of Margaret Lee, and she's the course manager of the dog grooming students. They're only a small group, but they've done so well this year. Courtney Amos takes the award for the level 2 dog grooming. She's a dedicated student who is committed to her work. She puts the utmost effort into everything that she undertakes. She's enthusiastic, she's a popular member of the group, she's compassionate to others, but she's compassionate also to the dogs and understands their welfare. She's been an absolutely perfect student, and Margaret and the team wish her all the very best for the future. Well done, animal carers. Thank you.
And so we move from the smaller animals to the larger animals. So if we can pass over to Susanna. I know she has got a few broadband issues, so if she does drop out, we duly apologise. But we hopefully go across to Susanna now for our Equine Awards. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Congratulations and well done to all of our Level 2 and Level 3 Equine students. You have been an absolute joy to teach this year, and overall we have had a very fabulous and very successful 1920 academic year. It gives me great pleasure to award the Newton Rigg Prize for Equine to Charlotte Graith. From the very beginning, Charlotte has impressed staff with her commitment and mature, can-do, will-do attitude, regardless of whether completing practical or theoretical tasks. Throughout the course, Charlotte has produced work of a consistently high standard, achieving a distinction grade in the end of year exam, which is testament to her enthusiasm and dedication. We as a team feel that Charlotte is a real asset to the college and look forward to welcoming her back in September to resume the second year of her studies. Well done, Charlotte.
just a touch, baby. I look around, since city's cold and empty. No one's around to judge me. I can see clearly when you're gone. I said, cause I can see the sunlight up the sky. So I hit the road in overdrive.